that my heat.
I just burned my mouth so bad leading up. Are you doing? What are you doing? Are you leaving?
Yeah, I'm gonna go home. I got a package.
Damn, bro, you getting packages every day?
I ordered 2 pair of shoes like 2 weeks ago.
Crazy.
I don't even know what's
up. Bro's got a new package a day.
Every day, bro. All
right, so we're at the GBT HQ. I was looking for some.
Oh, shit.
Bro, you used your laptop to switch that thing on?
Oh, yeah.
Holy.
But, just getting this pre-workout meal in. I was editing a TikTok earlier, and I'm looking for some people that we can potentially onboard as ambassadors. I got like a list of 7 to 8, but it's pretty much it. It's a Wednesday, so you know how the Wednesday workouts go. They're boring, and it's just something to get through. So I'm just trying to fuel up right now so we can get through this workout, go home, and then tomorrow we have deadlifts, but we're also going sneaker shopping tomorrow morning with Gia and Dion. So that'll be fun. I don't know if I might just be window shopping. I might not buy anything because shoes be hella expensive nowadays, but we're just gonna have to see. So I'm gonna get some food in and then we're gonna see you guys at the gym.
I should probably censor that, huh?
What? Fuck it. Okay. No, we don't. They don't know what it is. Like, they don't know about the, they don't know the label or nothing, so.
You want to stop it one more time?
Yeah. Do you want to say it again?
You're fine. All right. Okay.
It's gonna be shoulders, arms, and triceps.
All right.
I'm looking for like the one hammer strength zone.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of like.
Let's go. We see the hype outside, right from the house. Took it straight from outside, straight to the couch. We put the mic outside, edit shit out. You letting the scouts outside. We running the scouts. Ain't no control in the game. They never leave. I got tests over my veins, cause that what I bleed. She drink a lot of the bourbon, like she from the street.
Alright, so we just finished up the bodyboarding. Fuck. We just finished up the bodybuilding portion of the workout. Here at Alpha Land. I think I like working outside in the other gym more, just cause, I don't know, I like being down in this Texas heat. I'm used to it now, or I'm getting used to it more. So I don't wanna be like in the air conditioning. I just feel like my blood, there's not as much blood flow, and I just like, I don't know, I don't feel as warmed up when I'm in this air conditioning. So, I don't know, there's just some thoughts. We'll close it out for the day. We'll be back tomorrow for some sneaker shopping tomorrow morning, possibly. Or we'll just get straight to deadlifts. Just gonna go with the flow, see what's happening. But yeah, we'll catch you guys then.
Hey yo, Russ, we got
Up the price. Look at this shit. $255.
Dude,
we're about to up the prices. You better cop while you can.
Fuck, man. We bet. Is there anything that intrigues you, man?
Not here, no. I was expecting this boutique store to have a little bit wider of a shoe selection, but they don't. I was looking up. I don't know if I just want to spend like $150 on a hoodie right now or like a long sleeve, but probably go to like premium something, but something with more shoes, because that's really what I'm trying to pick up today. I feel like I have enough tops, or I get enough tops through other companies and shorts. But
actually, show them the fit real quick.
Yeah, show them the fucking
show
fit.
Show them the fit.
All right, so we got the Corrupted Tee releasing this Saturday, I think, online. And then we got the GBT exclusive shorts. Now I'm saying you can't get these no more. We did a pre-order for them. Gone forever. If you haven't joined the GBT Discord, join now, because you're missing out on tons of shit that's coming out just because you're not in there. And then we got the UNC Ones X the 10. So something light, you know what I'm saying? Got a little special outfit today for deadlifts. You guys are gonna have to catch that later. But I don't know, we're just gonna visit a couple more stores, maybe pick something out. But then other than that, just get to the workout. But you know how when you walk in, like straight off rip, it just has.
Bro, Bath and Body Works will do that for your apartment. I'm telling you right now.
That's literally.
Yes, man, I'm telling you.
You're talking about this one?
And anything, just any candle. Their candles like illuminate, I mean, they make the whole room smell good.
Yeah, but the whole damn store smells like this.
Bro, Gia, right? These candles make the whole place smell good. Right?
Yes.
Yeah, like it, like oh, in my apartment.
I actually need to buy some for the gym.
Yeah, in my apartment, I buy one.
Like him?
No, I.
No, he's just like, if I buy one, like, will it make my whole apartment smell like Sijuan? Yeah.
Yes.
No, I have one. It doesn't make the whole apartment smell like that.
You have Bath & Body Works?
Yes.
But what'd you get?
I think you have
a three-way candle.
I don't know.
Like, it doesn't make the whole apartment smell like that. You know what I'm saying? You know how when you...
Well, obviously...
It makes like, the room. It makes the room smell like that.
Yeah, it's not going to make your fucking bathroom, man.
That's what I'm saying. Oh. The second you walk into here, like, the aroma hits you in the face, like, the whole thing, and nothing's lit. You know what I'm saying? I was saying that whatever...
Like, plug-ins and everything in here.
Oh, they probably do.
Yeah. I don't know. My apartment, whenever I light it, like, the whole place smells. But, I mean...
Oh, that's disgusting.
Right, you don't like that one?
What does it smell like?
That one looks like it would smell good, though.
Some type of weird X.
Spray. It's just like,
I don't like it.
I don't mind that one.
Really?
Yeah, you I think like this one's gonna smell good though.
Like X?
It doesn't smell like X. This one smells like sweet. I'm not the biggest fan of that one. Here, smell that one. But pretty good. Gorilla? I can see that.
Oh, it smells really good.
Gives you like a mic. This one right here. This one,
chocolate chip cookie.
Nah, I could. That would be good, like in the fall, like in the winter time.
What do you say about like candles you get?
Nah, it's seasons. Like it's summertime, right? So you gotta get stuff that smells fruity. Right. And stuff like
it's giving.
Yeah. So stuff like all this, I wouldn't do it. And stuff like the coconut lime, verbena, whatever. I'd get that. Just like something more fruity.
Yeah.
I know. You know, it's so funny that people like to say that. Like, I don't have 2 years.
This one, or? I like sugar smells. I think that's I always get like the same ones every time I come.
What's your go-to's?
I try to switch it up.
The eucalyptus.
Right?
Yeah. I do like relaxing. But I don't see that.
That middle one's pretty cool.
This one reminds me of my childhood.
Is it?
Coconut lime verbena.
Oh, shit. Is it? Yo, Russ. Russ, do what you got going on with the bag.
A bunch of candles, man. I mean, it's about that time of the year. I mean, I'm always talking about candles, and it's been such a long time since I had any. So it's just like, now I gotta make sure I have some for the next couple of weeks.
Yes, sir.
Super happy.
Oh, because like the one near your place, like closed right now.
Nah, this is so they used to have a Bath and Body Works like over here on the corner,
mm-hmm.
and I guess they closed and they opened this new location because this one's never been here before.
Oh,
so.
Sick.
Bro. Oh no, put it down.
My
Bro, that video is insane. Bro, that video is crazy. Nah, bro, Sam went dummy on that. Y'all good? I can't hear y'all. Yeah, bro, like I'm in Bath and Body Works and I literally just like had an accident. Oh yeah. If you're a real German.
Yo.
What's up?
That's the fit right there. That's the fit. Oh shit.
Team Japan.
Yo.
If you're a real gym rat.
That's crazy.
If you're a real gym rat.
You like it? It's probably like my favorite one. This one, Jesus. I have a bunch of others. I think it's the Great Britain one, and this one's my favorite one. Rat, the first time I ever wore this one.
Gyms like this, where it's easy to get a nice little pump.
What?
I like it a lot.
Bro, you never literally failed to like install me, bro. What the fuck? Damn.
Look good, feel good, lift good.
As you should.
That's literally what it's all about.
Performance is one thing, drip is forever.
Dude, it actually is. Holy shit.
What?
Garage gyms.
Stay in your shit. That's sauce right there, bro. This shit's forever.
All right, so we're here about to get this deadlift workout in. I wanted to thank all of you guys who have subscribed because we finally hit 10,000 subscribers on YouTube. I know it's not a lot, but it's a big milestone for me, and I'm appreciative of every single one of you guys that tunes into these videos just because I'm really trying to take my YouTube game to the next level. So this is the first milestone that I can really say that I'm proud of. So we're gonna get this deadlift workout in, and then after deadlift, while we're going through accessories, I put up an Instagram poll to get some, or an Instagram questionnaire box to get some questions for you guys, just that you guys wanna know, get to know me a little bit better. So during accessories, we'll be answering those questions just between sets, just talking about the things that you guys asked and me getting a little bit more in-depth that I can't really do during an Instagram story. So just give you guys like, my own voice, just me talking about things. But yeah, we're about to get this deadlift workout in, and then we'll see you guys for accessories. going?
Yeah.
Okay, so the first question we have is, what pre do you use for con? I'm asking because I'm gonna compete soon. So I only use 110%, which is on papasups.com or at 110% on Instagram. You can use code WEEZ to save 10% off. That's the only pre I use because it's third-party tested, so I know that it's not gonna be contaminated with anything and you're not gonna get popped if you compete in a drug-tested federation. It has just enough of everything that I need to really lock in. I don't really like taking pre-workouts at DMAA, and it's not like I can even take it regardless, but it just dehydrates me and makes me cramp up. So I just stick with 110%. It's perfect, it's all I need. That's the pre-workout that I recommend. They just came out with this orange soda flavor. That's absolutely gas. It's probably second best to my lemon lime flavor that I have with them, but that's currently out of stock. So the best you can get right now is orange soda. So you can squeeze to save 10% on that. And yeah. I have is thoughts on vaping. I don't know any real competitive athletes that vape in their spare time, like vape nicotine or any kind of vapor cart or jewel or whatever, maybe other than Garrett Fear, but he's built different. It's just not for me personally. I get if it's for other people, but it's just something that I personally don't like to do. I'm a size small because they run a little bit bigger in mine and other people's experience. But then in other sleeves, I'm a medium. In other FPD sleeves, I'm a medium. And then in Stoic sleeves, I'm extra small. It's just like, I don't know, a lot of sleeves vary greatly depending on the sizing. And then another question I had was, they said, congrats on the 10K. What are some goals that you have outside of fitness? And my thing is, I'm really trying to make it big in crypto. Like, I want to keep stacking, building my portfolio to the point where hopefully one day I might be able to retire off crypto. That's kind of an outside goal that I have away from fitness. Question I've gotten a lot as of recently is how people can get involved with GBT or potentially become an ambassador or an athlete. And ever since I came down here, I've probably received this like 24 times. And if I were to say a handful of things, one thing I would say is you want to look at what the other Get Better Today athletes have in common. See if you can kind of align yourselves with that or resemble that in a way. And like, you'll know what I mean kind of if you just kind of look at who we have signed. Another thing is just always be yourself, because if you're not yourself, eventually it'll reveal itself and it comes off and you'll come off as unauthentic and you won't really build that connection with your following that we really want to see. We want people to really be in touch with their following, whether it be communicating with them and engaging with them, or just kind of like, I don't know, some people have like a cult-like fan base, and that's always good because those people are like ride or die for that person. So if that person promotes something, people will buy into it. Another thing is to have some sense of style. You know, you like, we're into people and we repost people that buy our clothing and know how to piece it together with some with a nice outfit and have some kind of sense of style outside of just gym wear. You know what I mean? So if you know how to dress and you have a little bit of swagger to you, that's another thing that we really look for as well. And then obviously, you know, a following comes into it. A following is like a piece of it, as it is with all kind of like ambassadorships or athlete sponsorships or whatever. Just because we like companies have to be able to get their return as to what they're giving out, and like they have to be able to like it has to be like a mutually beneficial relationship, as in the athlete is receiving adequate goods from said company, and then also like the company is getting their return because the athlete is promoting said clothing and generating enough sales via commission in order to make it worthwhile for that company to be associated with said athlete. Another thing is we're looking to expand outside of just powerlifting or fitness. We feel like Get Better Today has a strong presence within the powerlifting world, so we're trying to expand to more of like a general fitness / bodybuilding type culture, but then even outside of that, just picking up people that help reinforce the idea that we're trying to create turn Get Better Today into more of a lifestyle / streetwear brand. So I'm not even looking at just powerlifters, not even just bodybuilders, not even just fitness people. I'm looking at people on TikTok that may dance, might be comedians, might might have a following for their sense of fashion and their ability to pose and model. So we're really just trying to expand our horizons outside of just powerlifting and fitness is pretty much the gist of it. Another question that a lot of people ask is how do they grow their social media? And I'm probably one of the worst people to ask just because I didn't intentionally try to grow my social media at first. It kind of just took off with me just posting my lifts. But one thing that I've learned over the years is, and like one of the major keys is to establish yourself on multiple social media platforms, whether that be YouTube, TikTok, Instagram. I'm really just trying to get into YouTube and TikTok right now. I wish I was posting more earlier, but I wasn't. But one thing is to like really just try to post high quality, consistent content across all platforms, because if you're able to post high quality content that kind of makes your content stand out from other people's, more people are going to gravitate towards that naturally. And then in addition, if you're consistent, it's good for the algorithm in the sense where said social media platform is going to push your content more to people's pages or explore pages or home pages or for you pages or anything. I think another thing that obviously helps is to just be strong, because people gravitate towards that. Or you don't even have to be strong, like whatever your niche is, you kind of have to find your own niche and find something that brings value to the table that other people value or that other people want to see or be a part of, you know what I'm saying? Like for example, my thing is I post high quality good content and I'm strong and I like wear nice shoes or whatever. Like that's my thing. It doesn't have to be everyone's thing, but you have to find your thing that separates yourself from other people in order to really stand apart and have people like gravitate towards that. So whatever that may be, whether your thing is fashion, you're funny, you just have to separate yourself from other people so that people gravitate towards that thing. I don't have a question off the top of my mind. I need to check my camera roll, but like my phone's like on 1%, so I've been having to like bounce between back and forth. Alright, so the last two questions we got, first one is, will you be in Vegas? Vegas. So I'm not competing at Mega Roll Nationals, but I will be there just to spot and load and handle for some flex people. So I fly in Thursday and I leave Sunday. I probably pop into the GBT booth that we're hosting occasionally or whenever I can, but I will be busy kind of in the back rooms, making sure that people are good to go during their warm-ups. So if you guys see me, feel free to come up, say hi, dab me up or whatever. And the last question is, what do you want to be doing in the next few years? Honestly, like, I'm right where I want to be right now in terms of being surrounded with the people that support and care for me and motivate me to keep pushing forward and whatnot. And I'm happy doing what I'm doing right now. So, I mean, I couldn't really ask for any other change. But other than that, I think we're going to wrap up the video. You guys enjoyed. First off, let's try to get 1,000 likes on this video. It might be tough, but I feel like if we get more likes on the video, it'll really help push videos through the algo. So if we can get 1,000 likes on the video, let's try to shoot for that. But other than that, if you guys enjoyed the video, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one. 'Cause I was made for this.